गवर्नर जस्टिस पी सदाशिवम, चीफ मिनिस्टर श्री पिनराई विजयन जी, माय कलीग इन यूनियन गवर्नमेंट श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, श्री अल्फोंस जी, एमपी श्री केवी थॉमस, एमपी प्रोफेसर रिचर्ड हे, एमएलए श्री बीपी सजिंदरन, कोचीले सहोदरी सहोदरन मारे, एलार्कोम अंटे नमस्कारम, आई एम हैप्पी टू बी हियर एट कोची. The Queen of Arabian Sea, the Blue Sea, the backwaters, the Great Periyar River, the greenery all around, and its dynamic people make Kochi indeed a queen among the cities. It was from here that the greatest Indian sage Adi Shankara embarked on his epic journeys across India to protect the Indian civilization and unify the country. Today is a historic day when the largest industrial unit of Kerala is entering in next phase of development. It is indeed a proud moment, not just for Kerala, but also for the entire nation. Bharat Petroleum's Cochin refinery has played a critical role in popularizing the clean fuel LPG among masses in Kerala and neighboring states for more than 50 years. I recall my childhood when I had seen many mothers struggling with the firewood stove in the kitchen. Ever since, I had always thought of improving their situation and providing healthy kitchens to the mothers and sisters of India. The Ujjwala scheme of the government of India is a way to realize the dream. I am happy that since May 2016, nearly 6 crore LPG connections have been provided to the poorest of the poor in our country under Ujjwala Yojana. Friends, more than 23 crore LPG consumers have joined the Pahal scheme. Pahal has helped in identifying ghost accounts, multiple accounts, and inactive accounts. Pahal has entered into the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest direct benefit transfer scheme in the world. Over 1 crore customers have given up LPG subsidy under Give It Up initiative. By doubling the LPG production with the help of recent expansion, Kochi refinery is making a great contribution toward Ujjwala. To overcome environment pollution, the government of India is promoting the use of environment-friendly transport fuel, that is CNG, by expanding the coverage of city gas distribution network in the country. After the successful completion of 10th CGD bidding round, more than 400 districts of country will be connected for providing pipe gas supply. The national grid or Pradhan Mantri Urja Ganga has also been created to have a gas-based economy and enhance the share of gas in the energy basket. The government has thought of developing additional 15,000 kilometers of gas pipeline network to cut down on import of crude oil. Government has taken decisive steps towards reducing imports by 10% and saving precious foreign exchange. To this end, the second generation ethanol through lignocellulose route has been adopted by oil PSUs for establishing 12 2G ethanol plants in 11 states. 6 MOUs have already been signed in this direction. The Indian refinery industry has done well in establishing itself as a major player globally. India, which is second largest oil refinery in Asia, is emerging as a refinery hub with refining more than its demand. The country's refinery capacity is currently more than 247 MMTPA. I take this opportunity to congratulate all for the timely completion of IREP. Last but not the least, I recognize the work of all those laborers who work day and night during construction. I am told that at the peak of the project, over 20,000 laborers were working at the site. In many ways, they are the real heroes of this project. The integrated refinery expansion project was also a strategic move of Bharat Petroleum to diversify into non-fuel sector. My friends, petrochemicals are a grade of chemicals which we do not speak much about, but they exist invisibly and touch many aspects of our daily life. This includes building materials, plastic and paints, footwear, clothing and other fabrics, or automotive parts, cosmetic and medicines. However, most of these chemicals are imported from other countries. It is our endeavor to see that these petrochemicals are manufactured in India itself. I am happy that using the capability of Kochi refinery to produce propylene after the execution of IREP, BPCL has gone ahead with putting up 3 world-scale plants to manufacture acrylic acid. Acrylate and oxo alcohol under Make in India. These niche petrochemicals will find a use in paints, ink, coating, detergent, and in many other articles. Now BPCL is starting the construction of a petrochemical complex where it would produce polyols that find end use in form fibers, footwear, cosmetics and medicines. I'm sure by all these many ancillary industries would come to Kochi. I hope the petrochemical park planned by state government would become operational soon and leverage the business opportunities provided by the petrochemical venture of BPCL. I am happy to note that BPCL, along with other PSUs, has set up a skill development institute for skilling and developing employable youth. I am delighted to lay the foundation stone of the second campus of the institute at Etmanur near the holy Mahadev temple. I am also glad to note that Indian Oil Corporation has put out the mounted storage facility at its Cochin bottling plant around 10 kilometers from here at a cost of rupees 50 crores. This will enhance LPG storage capacity and also reduce road movement of LPG tankers. It is heartening to note that last August, when Kerala was passing through the worst floods in 100 years, BPCL Kochi refinery was kept running against all odds. I understand that many employees stayed in the refinery to ensure continuous production of petrol, diesel and LPG. This helped the rescue vehicles and helicopters to continue relief and rescue operations smoothly. I urge BPCL Kochi, this refinery, to keep up the spirit of hard work, social commitment and innovation as it moves toward its next phase of development. We are proud of Kochi refinery's contribution towards nation building. But now, we have greater expectations. I wish that Kochi refinery leads a petrochemical revolution in southern India and support the growing needs of a new India. Thank you very much.